Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. The graduation ceremony for the Bangkok Patana class of 2016 is about to begin. Could I please now ask you to turn off, not to turn off your mobile phones, but if you could put them onto silent mode or airplane mode, that would be really helpful to make sure they don't go off during the ceremony. And can I also please just to check where your nearest exit is, just in case of an emergency. Honoured guests, parents, colleagues and students, could you please be upstanding for the procession of the Foundation Board and the Academic Leadership Team of Bangkok Patana School.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the processional of the graduating class of 2016. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain upstanding for the Royal Thai Anthem, sung today by Rung, and followed by the British National Anthem, sung by Rosie, accompanied by Holly. Please be seated. Thank you to Rung, Rosie and Holly for those, and sorry about the microphone issue at the start. I'll just give a minute for a few people to be seated at the top there. Very good afternoon, everyone, and it is my absolute pleasure to welcome you all to the Bangkok Patana School Class of 2016 graduation ceremony. Very special welcome to our Foundation Vice Chairperson, Mrs. Laura Stamp, Foundation Board members, staff and teachers, parents, grandparents, brothers and sisters, relatives, and especially the Year 13 class of 2016. I'd also like to do a little special welcome and a message to our beloved office manager in the secondary office, Kun B, who has attended 15 Patna graduations, and she'll be completing her 30th year of service at Bangkok Patna. I think that deserves a clap. I don't know where you are, Kun B, but it's great to have you here. It's been an absolute pleasure knowing this year's graduating class for 8 years. You are a cohort who offer a wide array of talents, are passionate about life, and are well known for your diligent dedication towards your academic studies. I must say you have been well led and supported by your head of year, Ms. Yvonne Brown, who has built up a tremendous rapport with you all over 3 years. As a class, you have not only studied hard, but you have devoted your precious time into service, the environment, sports, music, drama, the visual arts, MUN, leadership projects, and the Gold Award. It's been an incredibly active and at times stressful year for all of you, but you have made it, and you are about to proudly come up onto this stage and be acknowledged for reaching your full potential. At this time, I would like to welcome to the stage our senior delegates, Holly, Sonal, Priyansh, Seb, and Kate, who will share some reflections with you all. Thank you.
On behalf of the senior delegates, I would like to greet families, faculty, the board, and of course, the illustrious class of 2016. A year and a half ago, we were all honored with the role of representing the passionate voice of Grad 16, and today we stand here to do so for the last time. As I look at the wonderful faces of my peers, I'm reminded of the mutualistic relationship between individuals and the communities surrounding them, and I can wholeheartedly say that Bangkok Patna has shaped and touched every single one of us. Teachers, thank you for having given us one of the most powerful and enduring gifts, a gift that closes the empty voids of oblivion and opens up a myriad of doors of opportunities, the gift of knowledge. Yet, the knowledge we embraced from teaching was also enriched by experiences both inside and outside of classrooms. Whether they were mesmerizing adventures to Everest Base Camp, using the electron diffraction tube in our state-of-the-art science lab, competing overseas in both academic and sports conferences, developing our leadership and global values in various cat clubs, or performing amidst the grandeur facilities in a school play. We have Patna to thank for fostering these opportunities. It is imperative, however, for us not to overlook those that have been with us since the very beginning, our families. Thank you for making it possible for us to be standing here today, for always being there for us despite our mistakes, and simply for your unconditional and selfless love. So once again, thank you to all who have influenced us. One way or another, you have made us resilient and given us confidence, and for that, we are eternally grateful.
Regardless of whether we came to the school in nursery or only arrived recently from a foreign land, Patna has given every member of our year group a feeling of permanency. As international students, we are like hermits, or perhaps hermit crabs, wandering a vast ocean in search of a shell to call home. And a shell is exactly what Patna has provided all of us. Primary teachers, PE teachers, secondary teachers, administrative staff, our extracurricular instructors, and even the gardeners, bus drivers, and maids, to all of which we owe immeasurable thanks, have given us the strength and intelligence to survive a turbulent world. But most importantly, Patna has given us a home, an abiding community of our parents, teachers, and peers to fall back on whenever we encounter adversity or seek guidance to grow. We will never forget the countless faces that raised us, nurtured us, because we will remember that the origin of our protective shell, one which will carry us far in life should we use it correctly, was right here at Patna.
And so, here we are, graduating. A day I know we have all been looking forward to for so long, and rightfully so. Today marks our conquering of the gauntlet that was the IB, the completion of the marathon that was school. More than anything, today is the culmination of our entire journey through primary, secondary, and senior studies. Through the pressure of deadlines and work, the sheer joy of learning that our teachers fostered within us, and the genuine care and support from our friends and families, we've emerged from this crazy adventure triumphant. I think it's important for us to absorb that. Be proud of what you fought through, accomplished, and experienced to get here. Because sometimes we forget. We keep wanting to move forward, that we simply forget. We forget that all this reality around us, right now, at this very moment, was once only a dream. And though we may be separated by oceans and continents in the near future, it's our day today. So let's all revel in it together. Grad 16, look to the future fearless. Reminisce about the past, having no regret. And today, before you walk across the stage, take a step back and take a moment to absorb it all. Don't take too long, though. We have to do everything in a pretty timely manner. But all in all, think of yourselves as legends today. Because I believe we all are, and we always will be, forevermore.
And yet, every legend has its own story. There were times, especially in the past term, we brought our broken selves in for show and tell in school, but never tell. Because how could you hold your ground if you felt everyone around you wanted to bury you beneath it? Because failure can intoxicate you, but it can also revive you. Having lived in many countries, I've learned from a very young age to live with uncertainty and open my mind. Because whilst it's nice to stick to the rules, it's when you break them, when you truly realize if you love your dreams enough to chase after it. I confronted failure repeatedly, but I had family, friends, and teachers, and I could not feel more accepted in this world of rejection. You do not learn failure in a classroom. You have to experience it. Because the funny thing is, when you open your mind, it's like opening a Pandora box, filled with a plethora of beautiful ways to live life. And liking the original Pandora box, there's a little voice, not of hope, but fear. And all too often, this is the fear of failure. But I'm standing here today to tell you to embrace failure. Let it revive you. Do not fear it.
We are all very lucky to have faced these obstacles together, in each other's company. And that is such a key attribute of the graduating class of 2016. We are always looking out for each other. Not only when we thrive, but also during hardship, from the infamous completion week to the intensity of our final exams. Did we succumb to the whip? Nay, nay. We were all in this together. An inseparable bond was formed. Some may say that blood is thicker than water, but water runs much deeper. And that is very true for our year. Our friends have become our family. I hope the friendships that we have formed here today continue to flourish and grow. Should our paths cross again in the future, and I hope they will, we can reflect on the amazing experience that was Patana, because at least we stole the show. Next, I'd like to welcome up Mr. Roth and Ms. Brown up onto the stage. Thank you.
So can I please just confirm that you've read and understood the notice to graduates? Can I also please ask you if anyone has anything unauthorized in your possession? This is your last opportunity to declare it before it is considered a breach of graduation regulations. Sorry, yes, year 13. It's a bit of a force of habit and probably actually an invitation for trouble, so I'm going to move on. Grad 16, it has been a wild ride, and that puts me in mind of journeys in Bangkok, something that you're going to be all too familiar with. The exam season certainly makes you think about and plan your trips very well, and account for all that Bangkok traffic. I was very pleased that we didn't have any problems with exams being interrupted as a result of those. One way to avoid the traffic and dependably get to your destination is to take the SkyTrain. And that made us think that your school experience has been very much like a SkyTrain ride. Consider yourself on the SkyTrain along with hordes of other people getting on back in the early years at Siam, asking the question, who am I?
Some of you may have become a little confused at Siam and been swept away with the crowd onto the wrong line. You were not the confident young adults that I see before me today and felt much safer in numbers. Not sure whether there's a CAS lesson this week? Oh well, I better stay here in senior studies with everybody else. Not sure whether you can take food on the BTS? Oh well, I'll just take one piece of pizza. I'm sure I saw someone else do that. At times, did you take a wrong turn and find yourself in deep water at Sapan Taksin? Did you end up shopping at Chatuchak rather than revising? Did you end up at National Stadium playing sport instead of doing homework sometimes? Who helped you get back on the right track?
At the start of your journey from Siam to Bering, it's very busy. You're lucky to get a seat, somewhere to hold you safe and secure and comfortable. The seat is a little like your teacher in your younger years, strong support from which to launch yourself. We're very pleased to have been able to offer each of you a seat on the Patana SkyTrain. As the train ride continues, people leave the carriage, just like many of your friends who have shared your Patana journey with you. You probably stay in touch with them using Facebook on your phones, like 99% of SkyTrain passengers. Others have got on the stations at stations along the way and are completing your journey with you. A few of you, just like the old SkyTrain user, have been completely oblivious to all of this because you've been plugged into music. How have you made yourself stand out from the crowd? Either good things, or have you suffered the whistle of wrath from Miss Brown because you've put your toe over the yellow line on the platform? As the crowd thins out, you've had the space to move around and express yourself more. Your teachers have become more like the handrails on the SkyTrain, something to grab onto for support as you need it. It is inevitable that you'll lose your balance occasionally due to a bumpy track or a surprise corner, but less constraining than a seat at a time when you need the freedom to move. At this point, I think it's worth stopping and bearing a thought for your long-suffering parents who have had to evolve from the most secure and comfortable of seats into strong and very discreetly placed handrails. Apologies, parents, that possibly isn't the most flattering of analogies.
So you've all been on this Patana train ride together, but what happens when you reach the end of the line? Do you need to be woken up, like in the morning in senior studies? Do you have a good moral compass for life and know which bearing will lead you to happiness and successful adulthood? Is your life going to stay on the right track? We hope that you've learned more on this journey than how to solve an equation, string what started as a vague idea into a 4,000-word extended essay, and put your calculator in and out of press-to-test mode. You are thoroughly lovely young people, caring, funny, and aware of the world around you in a way that cannot be said of many 18-year-olds. You have listened to advice and tried to avoid being on our naughty lists. You have made me laugh on a daily basis and cry slightly less than this, sometimes in frustration, and often because of a kind gesture. You have learned how to be tolerant of others in a community, even when year seven students put food in your hair and pushed in front of you in the noodle line. You have been supportive of each other and caring when life has had a few potholes along the way. As you start the next part of your journey, the first thing you should do is throw away the map and begin to draw your own. You have choices to make at many of the stations along the way. How are you going to continue your journey from here? Mr. Roth is on his bike. And I'm taking an Uber. You only live once. It was an empty bottle, I promise. And it wasn't me that emptied it. Could I please invite Mrs. Laura Stamp, Vice Chairman of the Foundation Board, and Mr. Matt Mills, Head of School, to the stage to present the diplomas to the graduating class of 2016. First, I would like to invite Mr. Adrian Palmer, tutor of 13A, to the stage. Adrian has been 13A's tutor for the last 4 years.
Cleona has been at Patna for 15 years. Her most memorable moment is when she trekked to the Everest Base Camp with the Duke of Edinburgh's International Award, and she plans to study biomedical sciences in York. Beatrice Dominique Morales de la Fuente. Bea has been at Patna for 7 years. Her most memorable moment is when she co-founded the World Food Project with Rhea and Janice, and she plans to study in Melbourne, Australia next year. Eugene Grimaud. Eugene has been at Patna for 7 years. His most memorable moment was the CSAC rugby. He is planning on taking a gap year before studying a business-related course. Maria Teresa Hotmasara. Maria has been at Patna for 4 years. Her most memorable moment was the ESS trip, and she plans to study at Glion Institute of Higher Education next year. Napat Sorn Lojanovanic. Jenny has been at Patna for 7 years. Her most memorable moment was the year 7 residential. She is going to study business in the UK. Apoorva Mahajan. Apoorva has been at Patna for 4 years. Her most memorable moments were when she took part in the school productions, and she plans to study at the University of British Columbia next year. Abranil Mighty. Riju has been at Patna for 8 years. His most memorable moment was the art relief trip in Chiang Mai, and he plans to study at King's College London next year. Zaid Youssef Normand. Zaid has been at Patna for 8 years. His most memorable moment is playing Demetrius in the school productions of Midsummer Night's Dream, and he plans to study at Bard College. Krusha Singh. Krusha has been at Patna for 8 years. Her most memorable moment is when she went on the Year 12 geography trip, and she plans to study international business at James Cook University in Singapore. Panarin Sankaboon. Panarin has been at Patna for 5 years. His most memorable moment is when he went to CSAC in Hong Kong during Year 11. He plans to study business at the University of Michigan next year. Kevin Switala. Kevin has been at Patna for 11 years. His most memorable moment was the Year 12 geography trip, and he plans on taking a gap year before returning to study. Anselm Xavier. Anselm has been at Patna for 4 years. His most memorable moment is when he qualified for finals in the Thailand National Age Group Swimming Championship, and he plans to study forensic science at Northumbria University next year. Rajavi Yadav. Rajavi has been in Patna for 8 years. Her most memorable moments include being part of the under 17 JV softball team in year 12. She plans to go to the School of Visual Arts in New York and study multimedia. Christina Zellerback. Kit has attended Patna for 14 years. And her most memorable moments are every history lesson with Mr. Darby. She plans to study computer science and engineering at Worcester Polytechnic Institute in the US next year.
Right up to the line. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you 13A. Next, I would like to invite Mr. Mike Brooks to the stage. Mike's the tutor of 13B, and he's been with them for the last 2 years.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to welcome on stage the graduating class of 13B. First up, we have Trinh Anh. Andy has been at Patana for 16 years. He now plans to study law at Thammasat University. Chaninda Dejsupa. Holly has been at Patana for 7 years. Her most memorable moment was playing her original composition with the jazz band at Patana Jazz and Blues. Holly will now go on to study medicine at Bristol University. Samakorn Duntanasarn. Mike has been at Patana for 6 years. His most memorable moments were his climbing competitions, and he now plans to study finance at Stern School of Business at New York University. Meg Jane. Meg has been at Patana for 8 years. His most memorable moment is this very graduation ceremony. He now intends to study business at Pepperdine University in the US. Tipop Kiran Suntongpong. Float has been at Patana for 14 years. His most memorable moment was his Khao Kon Chai military camp, and he plans to study computer engineering at Northwestern University in the US next year. John Young Lee. Young has been at Patana for 13 years. His most memorable moment is completing the Silver DOE trekking expedition. He now plans to go on to study chemical engineering in Germany. Chichanok Longaunu. Visney has been at Patana for 14 years. Her most memorable moment was exhibiting her own artwork in the IB Art Exhibition. Now she plans to study architectural engineering in the UK. Priyansh Lunia. Priyansh has been at Patana for 13 years. Amassing a plethora of wonderful memories which he will cherish forever. His most memorable moment was his trek to the Everest base camp. Next year, Priyansh will be living the adventure by exploring the world and his mind before pursuing further study in applied physics and engineering. Joshua Moe. Joshua has been at Patana for 9 years. He's living his most memorable moment right now. He plans to read law at Durham University. Gerald Obog. Gerald has been at Patana for 5 years. His most memorable moment was when he managed to finish his computer science coursework. And he now plans to study computer science in Thailand. Honami Ota. Honami has been at Patana from year 1 to 8, then she returned in year 12. Her most memorable moment was just being among such great people. After Patana, she plans to study biological sciences at Toronto University. Warinupa Pornprapa. Baby has been at Patana for 15 years. Her most memorable moment was her work in Amnesty, and she plans to study liberal arts at Pomona College next year. Emma Rainsford. Emma has been at Patana for 4 years. Her most memorable moment was her maths class with Mr. Aitchison. She plans to continue her studies now in Melbourne. Saranta Sangsuan. Sarah has been at Patana for 10 years. Her most memorable moment was when she went on the Verbier ski trip, and she plans to study computer science now at Queen Mary College in London. Kan Vantanasuksan. Kan has been at Patana for 10 years. The thing that most sticks in his memory is completing his ROTC training at Khao Chongai Military Camp, and he plans to study engineering at the University of Texas in Austin next year. Lastly, we have Natasha Zimmerman. Natasha has been at Patana for 7.5 years. Her most memorable moment was trekking to Everest Base Camp. After Patana, she plans to study economics and history at the University of Toronto.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you 13B. I would like to invite Adam Chidell, tutor of 13C, to the stage. Adam has been 13C's tutor for the last 2 years.
Tanachot Altri. Toby has been at Patna for a total of 7 years. His favorite memory from his time here was going on the school ski trip with a group of his friends. Toby plans to study physiotherapy at the University of Melbourne next year. Darshan Bikadia. Darshan started at Patna 9 years ago, but his favorite memory is from just last year, when he took an active role in the Year 12 Residential Fashion Show. Darshan's plans for next year are to begin studying computer science in the US. Marcus Cabell. Marcus joined Patana 11 years ago. His favorite moments here have been DJing at various school events, including proms and dances. Marcus will be studying biotechnology at the University of California, Davis next year. Rachel Ho. Rachel has been a Patana student for 8 years. Her favorite moment was completing her final art exhibition with, for the first time ever, more than 24 hours to spare. Next year, Rachel will be studying architecture at either Bath or Edinburgh. Safwan Khan. Saf started at Patana 8 years ago. His highlights have been the close friendships he's made over his time here. As of next year, Saf plans to be studying computer science somewhere in the UK. Haintet MacArthur. Haintet joined Patana 7 years ago. His favorite memories include the scuba diving trips he went on with the Patana Marine Conservation Group. Haintet has secured a place at the United States Naval Academy in Annapolis, Maryland. Frances McWhirter. Frances has been a Patana student for 9 years, and one of her fondest memories is golden time as a student in the primary school. Frances will be studying psychology next year. Ian Russell Nicholson. Ross has been at Patna for 12 years. His highlights from his time here were winning under-19 BISAC championships in both football and rugby. He will be going to Loughborough University to study sport and exercise science. Tarwin Matthew Nunpakdi. Matthew has been a Patana student for 10 years. He fondly recalls performing ventriloquism in year 5. Matthew plans to study film production and hopes to pursue his passion for playing chess. Aisha Jessica Penwarden. Aisha joined Patana 12 and a half years ago. Her favorite memory from her time here is dancing to the party rock anthem along with other members of the 8J tutor group. As of next year, Aisha will be studying art and design at Falmouth University. Aarti Prabhu. Aarti joined Patana 5 years ago and will look back at the Year 10 Global Perspectives trip as one of the highlights of her time here. Aarti will be studying international business at university in the UK next year. Ashana Pusagoda. Ashana has been at Patana for 9 years and has particularly enjoyed the variety of school trips she's been on, including D of E, biology field trips, and CSAC competitions. Next year, Ashana plans to study economics in Australia. Kanika Ratnakovic. Kanika has been at Patna the longest out of everyone in the tutor group, a total of 13 years, and her favorite memory was the year 2 sleepover. Next year, Kanika plans to study business fashion at the University of Arts in London. Millie Ribeiro. Millie has been at Patana for 10 years. The highlight of her time here was last year's CSAC swimming competition in Hong Kong. Next year, Millie will study commerce at Melbourne University. Melissa Surapad Pichai. Melissa joined Patana 7 years ago. She was especially proud of finishing a major long-term DT project recently. Melissa will be heading to the US to study psychology. Gilbert van Gerven. Gilbert has been a Patana student for 9 years, and his favorite memory is making the under 15 basketball team for the first time. Gilbert now plans to complete 2 years of national service in Singapore before traveling and then attending university in Europe. And finally, Aisha Waldi. Aisha joined Patana 6 years ago. Her favorite experience while here was taking part in a Duke of Edinburgh expedition to Hong Kong. Aisha will now be heading to Erasmus University in Rotterdam to study psychology.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you 13C. Next, I would like to invite Ms. Nita Juice, tutor of 13D, to the stage. Nita has been 13D's tutor for the whole of secondary school, which is 7 years.
Yeah, so just before introducing them, I just want to say what a privilege it's been to have been their tutor for that long. And a bit like you, I'm sort of wondering how they all got so big and beautiful so quickly. So the first person I'd like to introduce is Andrew Broadbent. Andrew has been at Patna for 7 years. His most memorable moment was when he built an artificial reef with his friends for the Patna Marine Conservation Group. He's planning on studying mechanical engineering at the University of Waterloo in Canada. Olivia Carr. Liv has been at Patna for 9 years. Her most memorable moment was when she went on the Gold Duke of Edinburgh Everest Base Camp trek in Nepal. She plans to study urban planning at the University of Manchester next year. Anthony Catterwell. Anthony has been at Patna for 16 years. His most memorable moment at Patna was his first CSAC swimming championship in year six. He plans to study computer science at the University of Edinburgh next year. Neelesh Chatterjee. Neil has been at Patna for 2 years. His most memorable moment at Patna was listening to Mrs. Brown's inspiring speeches. He plans to study biomedical science at Imperial College London later this year. William de Biowen. Will has been at Patna for 4 years. His most memorable moment was having the strength to make it through and finish IB. He plans to study for a Bachelor of Commerce in Law in Melbourne, Australia. Jolie Jean. Jolie has been at Patna for 14 years. Her favorite moment is when she finished her art exhibition and sighed with relief that she didn't have to go to bed late anymore. She plans to study graphic design in either Australia or Singapore next year. Ola Johannesson. Ola has been at Patna for 16 years. His most memorable moment is when he performed spontaneous drop rolls during registration, which was pretty often, and they would wake us all up. He plans to study computer science at the University of Aberdeen next year. Jitaran Kanjanapirod. Wynne has been at Patna for 16 years. His most memorable moment at Patna is competing in his first CSAC in Hong Kong when he was in year 10. He plans to study computer engineering at Thammasat University. Sonal Kuatra. Sonal has been at Patna for 14 years. Her most memorable moment at Patna were playing handball in the tutor base in year 8. She plans to study art and design at SCAD in the US next year. Alice Emily Osborne. Alice has been at Patna for 2 years. Her most memorable moment at Patna is graduating from this stage, right here, right now. She plans to study business management and Chinese at the University of Manchester next year. Natcha Ratanakul. Natcha has been at Patna for 13 years. Her favorite moment is Patna is when she exhibited her final artwork at this year's art exhibition. She plans to study film and animation at Rhode Island School of Design, New York, next year. Sukhapat Razimattat. Aik has been at Patna for 5 years. His favorite moment at Patna was winning the CSAC Badminton Championship this year. He plans to study international relations at American University next year. Sanadiya Soni. Sunny has been at Patna for 13 years. His most memorable moment at Patna is when he founded TechUp. He plans to study business at the University of Hong Kong. Sophie Tulloch. Sophie has been at Patna for 3 years. Her most memorable moment at Patna is being part of the CSAC swimming team. My most memorable moment of her was her finishing her IB theatre coursework. She plans to study war studies at King's College London next year. Sebastian John Walter Young. Seb has been at Patna for 9 years. His most memorable moment was going to the United Nations Centre in Bangkok to serve as president of the IASIS MUN International Court of Justice. He plans to study physics at the University of Southern California next year. Sean Yeo Yuen Feng. Sean has been at Patna for 2 years. His most memorable moment is right now, at this moment, graduating. He plans to study product design in Milan next year.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you 13D. That concludes the first half of our presentations, and it is my pleasure to now invite onto the stage the Year 13 Instrumental and Vocal Ensemble for the musical Interlude. I'm very proud that we have such a talented group of 18 musicians and singers in Grad 16 to perform for you today. They will be performing The Last Goodbye by Boyd Walsh and Boyens, led by Mr. Alec Bean.
Hello.
I saw the light fade from the sky. On a wind I heard a sigh. As the snowflakes come up, my fallen brothers, I will say this last goodbye.
Night is now falling, so ends this day. The rain is now calling, and I miss away.
A beautiful performance and such a fitting choice for this occasion. I'm not sure how, but they've managed to juggle rehearsals around a quite grueling IB exam schedule, and most of them have been committed members of the orchestra and choir for the whole of their time in secondary school. I would like to express my thanks to Alec Bean and Laura McCritchie for supporting and guiding them. Could I please invite Mrs. Laura Stamp and Mr. Matt Mills onto the stage to continue with the presentation of the diplomas to the graduating class of 2016. I would like to invite Mrs. Sally Madden and Mr. Clive Bryan, tutors of 13I, to the stage. Sally has been 13I's tutor for 3 years, co-tutor with Clive for the last two.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce the lovely 13I, starting with Aditya Ayla. Adi has been at Patana for 7 years. His most memorable moment is when he performed karaoke and raved during the Playing for Change in campaign week. Adi plans to study at Purdue University in the US next year. Satini Chattachinda. Nina has studied at Patana for 16 years. Nina's most favourite moment was spent out on the court in the fields playing sports. Nina's passion for sport has led her to pursue sport and exercise science at Loughborough University next year. Kunanon Chin. Joey has been at Patana for 16 years. His most memorable moments are many Patana classic concerts he's performed since 2010. Joey plans to study mechanical engineering at Virginia Tech in the US. Ellen Hagerloa. Ellen has been at Patana for, been studying at Patana for 10 years. Her most memorable moment include her participation in all the CSAC tournaments. She plans to study hospitality management at Ecole Hotel Area de Lausanne in Switzerland. Andreas Jensen. Andreas has been at Patana since year 9. His most memorable moment was his last CSAC in Jakarta. who plans to study chemical engineering in Australia. Melanie Coe. Melanie has been at Patana for 10 years. Her most memorable moments include her participation in multiple swimming CSACs with the legendary coach Cindy over the years. She plans to study biomedical science and has been offered a place at the University of Surrey in the UK. Nidhi Mehta. Nidhi has been at Patana since K2. Her most memorable moments were completing her bronze, silver, and gold Duke of Edinburgh's award, international award. She plans to study finance at Northeastern University in Boston. Nachui Poonked. Pang has been at Patana since year 8. Her most memorable moment include her participation in various Patana concerts and performing here today. She plans to study financial actuarial mathematics at UCLA in the US.
Sukhawat Razmetat. Om's been at Patana since year 9. His most memorable moments are CSAC badminton tournament, Singapore and Jakarta. He plans to study finance in the US next year. Christian Salche. Christian's been at Patana for 13 years. His most memorable moment is coming first place in his basketball varsity CSAC tournament. He plans to study hospitality management at the Hotel School, The Hague. Ova Schuppner. Ova has been at Patana for 4 years, and next year he's off to study mechanical engineering with management at the University of Edinburgh. One of his most fond memories is successfully competing the once-in-a-lifetime Mount Everest Base Camp trek as part of the Duke of Edinburgh's International Award at gold level. Rhea Shah. Rhea has been at Patana since K2. Her favourite memory is her trip to Everest Base Camp as part of the Duke of Edinburgh's Gold Award, and she plans to study medicine at King's College, London. Andre Springer. Andre has been at Patana for over 10 years. His most memorable moment has been when he went to CSAC for the first time with the softball team. He will be studying business at the University of Toronto in Canada. Vignesh Vijay. Viggy has been at Patana since year 9. His most memorable moment was when he realized he had 4 buddies on the free pizza lunch day. His future plan is to study mathematics with computer science at the University of Pennsylvania. Emery Vatuntian. Emery has been at Patana for 16 years. Her most memorable moments have been CSAC volleyball and tennis. And she plans to study product design or graphic design in the US next year.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you 13i. Next, I'd like to invite Miss Cathy McDonald, tutor of 13M, to the stage. Cathy has been 13M's tutor for the last 2 years.
I'd like to introduce 13M, Abigail Barton. Abby has been at Patana for 5 years. She particularly enjoyed the Year 12 residential. Abby plans to study sociology with social policy at the University of Bath. Paul Boulom. Paul has been at Patna for 6 years. His favourite memory is varsity rugby CSEC with the lads. He plans to study Bachelor of Science in International Hospitality Management at the Hotel School of Lausanne in Switzerland. Anna Debewan. Anna has been at Patna for 15 years. Her favourite memories are of the numerous debates in biology class. She plans to study psychology in Australia. Yu Fujishiro. Yu has been at Patna for 6 years. His most notable memory is of all the DJing he's done at Patna. He plans to study New Media Interactive Development at Rochester Institute of Technology. Donna Heckelman. Donna has been at Patna for 9 years. Her favourite memories are of all the Patna residentials. She plans to study international business at the University of Leeds. Catherine John. Catherine has been at Patna for 8 years. Her favourite memory is of the Year 12 physics trip. She plans to study product design at Middlesex University in London. Vaibhavi Kandaval. Puri has been at Patna for 5 years. She particularly enjoyed the Year 12 biology field trip. She plans to study medicine at the University of Dundee. Sungju Kim. Sungju has been at Patna for 4 years. His most memorable moment was performing in front of an audience at Patna Classic. He plans to study accounting and finance in Hong Kong. Ansh Malik. Ansh has been at Patna for 9 years. His most unforgettable moment is when he went to Everest Base Camp on the Gold Duke of Edinburgh's International Award. He plans to study marketing and advertising in America or Canada. Federico Perrin. Federico has been at Patna for 10 years. His most memorable moment was on the silver kayaking trip as part of the Duke of Edinburgh's International Award. He plans to study economics at Tilburg University in the Netherlands. Yeah. Devon Smith. Devon has been a Patana for 11 years. His most unforgettable moment was winning CSEC basketball. He aims to continue the family legacy at the College of Worcester, where he plans to study communications. Marcus Sues. Marcus has been a Patana for 10 years. His favourite memory is playing CSEC volleyball and rugby. He plans to study international relations and business in Australia. Alexander Wagginson. Alexander has been a Patana for 12 years. His most notable memory was his collaborative project in theatre. He plans to study psychology at Kingston University. And last but not least, Aria Zellerbach. Alex has been a Patana for 14 years. Her favourite memory was difficult to pick, but definitely on a school trip. She plans to study acting at Pace University.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you 13M. Next, it's my pleasure to invite Barry Oakes to the stage, 13O's tutor for the last 3 years.
Sawadee krap, good afternoon, everyone. My special welcome to the families of the graduates. It gives me great pleasure to introduce my tutor group, 13O, beginning with Alejandro Bassin. Alejandro has attended Patana for 7 years. Lunchtime basketball games are among his fond memories. Ale will be studying liberal arts at Whittier College in the USA. Chan Chanarat. Chan has been at Patana since nursery school. His favorite memory is cooking tasty dishes in curry club with friends. Chan will be studying communication arts at Chulalongkorn University here in Bangkok. Paras Doshi. Paras has attended our school since 2009. Morning registration times with friends give Paras very pleasant memories. He plans to study mechanical engineering at University College London. Janice Jean. Janice is a veteran, having attended Patna since K1 kindergarten. Favorite memories for Janice are of the CSAC badminton competitions. She will be studying chemical and biomolecular engineering at Rice University in the USA. Chaekorn Yus. Alan began at Patna in 2006, beating NIST in the basketball, yes, finals to win CSAC is Alan's best memory. He plans to study computer systems engineering at Loughborough University in the UK. Dijai Kosyabong. Dijai has attended our school since year three. Her favorite memory is of doing art experimentation in the art room. Dijai will be studying photography at the Pratt Institute in New York, USA. Jue Lee. Jue has attended Patna for the last 9 years. Year 10 residential trip has special memories for Jue. He plans to study economics in Canada. Jonathan Lowe. Jonathan has attended Patna for 15 years. His favorite memories are of Team B basketball. After military service, Jonathan plans to further his study of business at university. Ryan Mansour. Ryan has been at Bangkok Patna School since 2010. Going on the year 12 geography trip forms Ryan's favorite memory. He plans to study electrical engineering at Imperial College London, UK. Anya O'Neill. Anya started at Patna in senior studies year 12. She well remembers the biology residential in year 12, which she greatly enjoyed. She plans to train as a primary teacher at the University of Dundee in Scotland. Dhruv Patel. Dhruv has been at Patna for 2 years. His favorite memory is of representing Patna in the softball tournament. Dhruv will study business management at the University of Buffalo in the USA. Aoi Saito. Aoi has been at Patna for 2 years, senior studies. Her favorite memory is geography field trip in year 12. She plans to study political science at Waseda University in Tokyo, Japan. Yada Tanyadom. Tammy has been at Patna since nursery school. She has very fond memories of the Operation Smile trip. Tammy now intends to study fashion design at Parsons School of Design in the USA. Sutatada Watanavikin. Kate has been a student at Patna since year six. One of her favorite memories is competing in 8 amazing CSAC swimming competitions with her swim fam. Kate intends to concentrate on behavioral economics at the Wharton School, University of Pennsylvania. Finally, Kenshiro Yamashita. Ken began his Patna career in year 7. Every moment spent with friends form good memories for Ken. Ken will study law and politics at Nagoya University in Japan.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you 13-0. And lastly, I would like to invite Miss Helen Vincent to the stage. She's been 13V's tutor for the last 5 years.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to introduce 13V. Starting with Grit Chaiprasit. Tay has been at Patana for 16 years. His most memorable moment is winning CSAC tennis, and he plans on studying engineering in the UK. Tanya Mai Jansavangwong. Mai Mai has been at Patana for 13 years. Her unforgettable moment is when she went to Everest Base Camp. She plans to study biomedical science at UCL next year. Amanda De Silva. Amanda has been at Patana for 4 years. Unfortunately, she can't be with us today, but she plans to study at the National University of Singapore next year. So next we have Paisit Jienjit Lert. Duke has been at Patana for 12 years. He particularly enjoyed traveling to Sisaket on the Smile trip. Next year, he plans to study international politics and economics in Japan. Nalin Ganchanajari. Mare has been at Patana for 4 years. Her most memorable moments include the year 12 biology trip and her years in the volleyball team. Next year, she plans to study at the University of Surrey. Arin Kiangsiri. Ton has been at Patana for 9 years. He loved every second he spent in the water swimming for the school. He plans to study business at Emory University in Atlanta next year. Zeyu Kim has been at Patana for 8 years. Zeyu's unforgettable moments are the Vietnam trip in year 9 and further mathematics classes. She plans to study mechanical engineering in the US. Tanya Kotecha. Tanya has been at Patana for 5 years. Her most memorable moment was the week she spent on the biology trip in year 12, and she hopes to study political science at Claremont McKenna College. Dalan Masinzi. Lily has been at Patana for 6 years. Her most notable memory is when she went on the Japan trip in year 9. And next year, she plans to study chemical engineering at the University of Southern California. Lauren Morling. Lauren has been at Patana for 5 years. Her most memorable moment was the Everest Base Camp expedition, and she plans to study at York University in the UK. Utni Rungseng. Rung has been at Patana for 14 years. She has many fond memories from playing CSAC badminton. Next year, she plans to study journalism in Ohio Wesleyan University. Rosanna Houghton Schofield. Rosie has been at Patana for 15 years. Her most outstanding memory is performing in the Secret Garden. She plans to study theatre and English literature at Lancaster University next year. Abigail Scott. Abby has been at Patana for 5 years. She's thoroughly enjoyed all of the drama trips she's been involved in, and she plans to study at the University of Liverpool next year. Ashvin Sharma. Ashvin has been at Patana for 9 years. His most memorable moment is when he performed at Patana Unplugged for the first time, and he plans to study mechanical engineering next year at the University of Michigan. Lucas Stevens. Lucas has been at Patana for 5.5 years. He has really enjoyed playing rugby with such a great group of players and friends. Lucas plans to study in Australia. Manav Thacker. Manav has been at Patana for 14 years. He is proud of being chosen to play on the softball team. He plans to study public relations at Penn State University. Which brings me to the final student to graduate from Patana this afternoon, Denise Anne Marie Vallejo. Denise has been at Patana for 13 years. She particularly enjoyed the ESS trip to the mangrove forest with her friends. She plans to study international business management at The Hague University next year.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you 13V. Thank you, Laura and Matt. And could I now invite Mr. Mick Smith, Secondary Principal, to the stage for his closing remarks.
Graduates of 2016, family members, guests and colleagues. Before I begin my closing remarks, I'd like to thank a number of people for making today so memorable for you. This theatre is a stunning venue for such an auspicious occasion, and my sincere thanks go to the Army of Support Staff who've arranged the beautiful setup here and in the sports hall tonight. Thanks also to our catering, sound and lighting, ICT and marketing teams, the secondary office staff and the Year 13 tutors. Special thanks to Helen Few and Head of Year 13 Yvonne Brown for their meticulous planning and coordination from start to finish. Sincere thanks also to Alec Bean, Laura McRitchie, all of our talented musicians, and also to our senior delegates, who in addition to graduating themselves, had the added pressure of delivering their superb speeches. Thank you all very much indeed. This is my 10th graduation speech, and essentially I always want to say the same simple things. Congratulations. Now show us what you've learned, who you've become. Be good people with strong values. Lead happy and successful lives. That's basically it. So if you drift off in the next few minutes, I'll come back to that at the end. I usually begin by teasing gently our graduates for belonging to a generation whose senior studies soundtrack isn't defined by musical gods such as the Beatles, Bowie or Prince, both sadly departed, who inspired many of our school days, but by mere mortals of the new millennium, One Direction, Justin Bieber. Of course, 1D kind of died recently too. Sadly, I can't really mock this year, as either Bieber's getting better or I'm regressing to childhood. Recently, I've caught myself inanely babbling, baby, you should go and love yourself. Maybe Justin's growing up, which brings me neatly to our graduates. You've passed through Patana more or less unscathed and enormously enriched. You're positively bursting at the seams with ideas, skills, knowledge, and understanding. The IB learner profile flicks across your eyes like in a VR headset. Thinker, yes. Reflective, yes. Balanced, yes. Risk taker, oh yes. We can't contain you anymore. There's nothing more for us to teach you. It's time to leave us behind. Each year I struggle for metaphors that can possibly do justice to the momentous step you're about to take, leaving school, home, setting out independently for the first time. Last year, I cast the class of 2015 as mighty young trees bursting free of the canopy of the Patana forest beneath them, gazing at the enormous world beyond for the first time. Not bad, eh? I also said they'd spent their entire childhoods as hairy little caterpillars, transformed only into beautiful butterflies at graduation. And you? You're a supergroup. Not like 1D, though. You've consistently shone academically. Our highest achieving IGCSE students ever. No pressure. And through your enormous contributions to and leadership of our school community. You are artists, designers, scientists, athletes, activists. You've campaigned to raise our awareness of issues from mental health to human trafficking and sexual exploitation. You are kind, thoughtful, compassionate, and passionate. Determined and fearsome advocates for the issues you're deeply committed to and also for each other. You will not be ignored, but you will listen. You observe, consider, and you participate. When things are unfair or unjust, you act decisively. So the metaphor. I might have said superheroes ready to save the planet until that image was forever tarnished by some of the boys running around in tights and underpants during dress up week. I do think the world needs saving, though, and maybe you are the people to do it. You have outstanding leaders. We've seen some of them here today. As a group, though, like all good teams, you're even greater than the sum of your parts. I see you as being on a march, a mission, crusaders, an unstoppable force for good. If this were Hogwarts, then I guess Mr. Mills would be Dumbledore, but much faster and louder. Ms. Brown would be Professor McGonagall, keeping you on the right path. The IB coordinator always seems evil. Deadlines, the dreaded academic dishonesty detector. But it turns out he's been on your side all along. Mr. Roth has to be Professor Snape. The gentle giant Hagrid has his hut in seniors too, but he seems to have trimmed his beard today. And you? You're Dumbledore's army. Or Patana's army, prepared, brave, righteous, invincible, marching forward, ones at the ready. So what challenges await you now you've finally drawn a line under childhood and adolescence? Personal ones, learning how you respond to new situations and make decisions, establishing yourself in a career and a community, falling in love, falling out of love, The property ladder. Coping with no longer having an account at the bank of mum and dad. Other challenges may have a less personal impact, but will shape the world you inhabit. The first of these may well be Donald Trump. It is now possible that this man, treated as something of a joke candidate only a year ago, may be elected as president of the USA, as those of you heading stateside took into your first Thanksgiving dinner. Without becoming too political, my question is, why is such a divisive figure who openly promotes intolerance in so many areas, from the rights and roles of women, to religion, to sexuality, proving to be so popular among ordinary Americans? America isn't facing any traditional crises, economic meltdown, mass unemployment, that may lead to acceptance of such views. It is suffering relative decline as other nations catch up, but surely this doesn't explain his appeal. Something else must be wrong. There seems to be a disconnect between government and people. Sebastian, your peers voted you most likely to be president. Could you bridge that growing divide? The people of the UK decide this month whether to remain part of the European Union or strike out alone. There are strong arguments on both sides involving crucial issues of genuine democratic representation, social and cultural relations, political, strategic, military alliances. However, the focus seems to only really be on economic benefits. How much better or worse off will the UK be in each scenario? And on the potential negative influence of foreigners in Britain. Intolerance and prejudice are part of this debate too, to the extent that those with more sophisticated arguments for Brexit hardly dare speak out for fear of being labelled racists or xenophobes. The referendum raises big questions of national identity, societal values, the role of education, the UK's standing in the world. Currently, polls say the Leave campaign is slightly ahead. How would you respond, graduates, to such life-impacting decisions? I believe you'd inform yourselves fully, cut through the hyperbole, scaremongering, the name-calling, to evaluate the best way forward and make a reasoned, honest choice. I'm pretty sure many of you would also then be out there persuading others to agree with you. Here in Thailand, there are serious challenges for those of you who make your home here. The long-term goal of developing a secure and genuine democracy is proving to be a mighty challenge. It's now 2 years since the elected government, facing an increasingly ungovernable situation, was overthrown. Thailand is clearly more stable now than it has been for a number of years, to the credit of the current leaders. The country surely looks forward, though, to finding a way for its political leaders, representing the interests of the electorate, to coexist peacefully over a sustained period of time for the well-being of the nation. Perhaps some of you will take your place in Parliament here and strengthen democracy in Thailand in the future. It's interesting that as you graduate, the oldest parliamentary democracy, the UK, the leader of the free world, the USA, and Thailand, a major regional power, all face challenges to their democratic credentials. Intolerance of other views, other people, other religions, and other ways of living has risen since September 11, 2001. Widespread conflict based on intolerance has erupted in wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, and in the emergence of successive extremist terror organizations. The religious schisms between the generally Christian West and mostly Muslim Middle East are being portrayed by extremists as greater now than maybe any time since the Crusades 900 years ago. This is why Donald Trump feels it acceptable to suggest barring Muslims from entry to the USA. And why, sadly, many Americans, although a minority, agree with him. A number of you are studying international relations next year. Can you use your skills as global natives, seasoned intercultural diplomats, to find ways forward from this desperate current climate of fear and suspicion? From a global population of 7.4 billion, almost 800 million people have insufficient food to lead healthy, active lives. Poor nutrition kills 3 million children under 5 each year. Education is a key factor in the development of all countries, but in developing countries, 66 million primary age children go hungry at school. By 2050, when you're around the age of your parents, imagine that, the population will be 10 billion. Even worse, current farming methods are systematically depleting soil. Increasing meat consumption causes deforestation, and food production already contributes 30% of man-made gas emissions. Could you become leaders of companies already working on possible food technology solutions to produce food more efficiently and sustainably, or to reduce the disgraceful waste of almost a third of all food produced, 1.6 billion tons annually, while those 800 million people go hungry? Or could you lobby successfully for funding for this research? In Europe last week, more than 1,000 people died attempting to cross the Mediterranean from North Africa to Italy. Since early 2015, over 2 million migrants, many later classed as refugees, travelled to Europe, mostly from war-torn Syria, Afghanistan and Iraq. The response to this number of people trying to make a new, safer life in Europe has been mixed. Germany, Hungary, Austria, Sweden, Norway, Finland have led the way in offering safe refuge. However, intolerance, fear, concern for their own economic and social well-being, and the sheer number of migrants has hardened attitudes among European governments and people alike, following initial outpourings of empathy and welcome when the first casualties began washing up on European beaches. Could you offer solutions either to support these people in Europe, to advocate for them, or to work strategically to alleviate the poverty and brutal conflict that drives them towards Europe? I could go on and on for ages like this. The world always seems to be in a precarious position. Ongoing, seemingly ceaseless posturing in Korea. Turmoil rages on throughout the Middle East. The major economies of the world, or at least the Western ones, are trillions of dollars in debt. A huge challenge, of course, in your future will be the continued threat to the environment. We've all seen the tremendous vision, energy, and organizational skills of our student environmentalists amongst you. I'm very confident I can leave that particular problem in your hands. So, the world beyond Patana isn't quite as safe, caring, and inclusive as your home here has been. This is where we need the Patana Army, the positive force for good to come to the fore. I've spoken before of a Patana diaspora, alumni scattered worldwide, using values and skills developed here, continuing to learn, making a difference, leaving positive orange paw prints wherever you go. Could Patana's army be in the vanguard of genuine steps to implement decisive, wide-ranging measures to safeguard the future? Are you brave enough? Committed enough? I think so. Make good choices, ethical decisions, be kind and be happy. There are so many opportunities for you, so many amazing things to experience. And despite all its faults, it really is a wonderful world out there. I definitely do expect you to change the world for the better, both on a small scale and on big issues. I see it as your responsibility. Your parents have provided you with love and guidance, and in partnership with us, a superb education, a launchpad of opportunity afforded to few others. Now it's over to you. What kind of world do you want in 2050 and beyond? You have the opportunity and duty to shape it. You are fine young witches and wizards, sorry, women and men. It's time for you to rise to the challenge of the rest of your lives. You don't have to change the world immediately. Have a well-deserved rest, unwind for a while. Start when you get back from Samui. Congratulations and good luck to the graduating class of 2016. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the recessional of the graduates of 2016. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for attending the graduation ceremony for the class of 2016. Just a couple of quick notices for you. Outside the theatre on this level, there are drinks provided for the reception in both the exhibition hall and the foyer. USMAR photographers will be available in the sports hall, court 1, from 6:30 till 9:30. The dinner begins at 7 p.m. over in the sports hall. Please make your way there for 6:45. Once all guests have arrived on your table, please feel to go and help yourself to the meal. Can you just check you have all your belongings with you? And the final message I've been asked to share with you is please no food or drinking here. Thanks again for supporting your families. Have a great evening.